Hi everybody, welcome to lecture number 12, VoIP, Routing Interoperability through IP and PSTN. So in this lecture, we are going to cover the basic concepts of VoIP and also we are going to discuss about the interoperability through IP and also in the PSTN, so how the VoIP is going to be working. So VoIP is a huge topic, okay, it's a very big topic. There are so many different concepts, protocols, okay, are used in this concept. In this lecture, we are not going to cover everything. So we are going to give you an overall idea, okay, how the VoIP is working and how we can have the routing interoperability. Okay, that means how the routing interoperability is implemented through the IP and PSTN and basic things we are going to discuss. There are so many vendors, including Cisco, they are providing certifications in VoIP. So you can become VoIP expert. Okay, so there are a lot of VoIP specialists, okay, engineers, okay, working in the ISPs, internet service providers. So it's a big topic. So even if you are interested, you can become a VoIP expert. You can search it in the internet. What are all the VoIP certificates provided by various vendors? So you can get a big list. Okay, so if you are interested in this particular area, you can complete some certifications and you can work in VoIP also. In this lecture, we are going to cover four major things. So the first one is VoIP overview. So what is VoIP? What are all the different protocols used in VoIP? So this is we are going to cover in the part one, that is the VoIP overview. So in the second part of this lecture, applications of VoIP. So what are all the applications of VoIP protocol? We are going to discuss in the second part of this lecture. The third one, we are going to concentrate on the routing concepts. That means PSTN call routing, using internet and managed IP approach. So these are the two major concepts we are going to discuss. Call routing. Okay, so call routing using the internet and also call routing in the managed IP approach. So this is what we are going to cover in this particular lecture. VoIP stands for Voice over IP. Now, I included this slide. So this shows the VoIP architecture. So before discussing about the architecture and all, so I want to show you five different cases. Okay, you can see the five different cases here. So case one, the first case is landline to landline. That means from a PSTN telephone to a PSTN telephone, public switch telephone network to public switch telephone network. So that means in Oman, we know. So we are having phones in our home. Okay, that is a landline phone. Starts with two. The number will start with two. So 2, 5, 5, 4, 6, something, some numbers, it will start with two. Now, from the PSTN number to a PSTN number, you can make a call. So this is completely or purely it is going to be PSTN to PSTN call. So this is case number one. So this already we know, okay, this is a traditional one. So still we are using this. Okay, still it is in use, but it is expensive. So the calls are expensive. We need specialized hardware devices for doing this. Okay, and also there will be some disturbances. Okay, sometimes you may not get the lines properly. Okay, connectivity issues will be available. Okay, and the device is going to be fixed one. You cannot move the device. Okay, your landline device, that means the landline phone is going to be a fixed one. Okay, you can see like this. So there are some drawbacks available in this method, but it is a traditional method. Then the next approach or the next case is PC to PC. So calling from PC to PC. For example, I'm taking my Facebook. So I just logged in the Facebook. In Facebook, we have the messenger. From the Facebook messenger to someone who is online. My friend is also logged in the Facebook. He's also in online now. I'm going to call him. Okay, I'm going to call him and I'm going to chat with him. Okay, for example, we are doing with Zoom and there are so many applications available. So using that applications, you can make call. Okay, that is PC to PC. So completely it is going to be internet based. So this is the second way of making the calls. Then the third one is, you can see PC to landline. you can see the third and fourth, PC to landline and landline to PC. So that means from PC, from a personal computer, okay, to a landline number, okay, you can see in this case, I'm going to take this PC. So there is a software running here, any software you can take, an application layer. Now using that particular software, I'm going to call a landline number. Okay, you can follow the line now. So this is, I'm going to call this number. So this is going to be a PC to calling a landline, or you can go for the reverse. Okay, that means the vice versa. So what is that means? From this PC, sorry, from this telephone, okay, a landline number, a fixed telephone. So from here, I'm going to call this particular PC. So this concept also, it is possible. We are discussing the different cases. Then the last one is landline to landline through IP network. Through IP network, you can see in this diagram. Okay, so this is a PSTN telephone, a fixed line telephone. I'm going to call this number, this telephone, through the IP network. So my data, that means whatever the voice I'm calling, it should go only through the IP network. This is going to be the next case. So there are different cases I'm telling here, five different cases available. Just I'm repeating this, okay, in a simple way. Okay, what does that means? In a landline to landline, completely, that means your voice is going through a PSTN network only. You can see here, this is a telephone and I'm going to have a telephone, okay, here. Now I'm going to call these two numbers, okay, they are going to talk with each other. So this is completely inside a PSTN network, okay, a public switch telephone network. So there is no IP here. So this is the traditional one, this is the first type. The second one, PC to PC, this is going to be completely internet based. Okay, you can see here, there is a IP network available. So in this IP network, from this PC to this PC, I'm going to call, PC1 to PC2, I'm going to call. So completely your packets, or you can say the voice, okay, I'm not using the packet now, the voice, okay, voice data. Voice data is going to completely move in the IP network. Okay, it is going to move completely only in the IP network. Okay, so that is only IP network is used here. The third one you can see, PC to landline. So if you're going for PC to landline, so there are two different networks will be used here. Okay, or landline to PC. There are two different networks will be used here. What is that means? The one is the PSTN and second one is going to be the IP. So it is a combination of two things. So we are going to use the PSTN network and also we are going to use the IP network. So in these two cases. Then in the last case, landline to landline, okay, through IP. So here I'm going to completely remove the PSTN concept, public switch telephone network concept, completely I'm going to remove only, okay, through the IP network, landline to landline, through IP network I'm going to call. So these are all the different cases, okay, different cases. So how to implement, we are going to see in the coming slides. Now I'm going for topic number one. That means the first topic in this lecture, VoIP overview. So VoIP, voice over IP, is a layer 3 protocol. So layer 3 means, we already know, it is a network layer protocol. Layer 3 network layer protocol. Then there are so many protocols. That means we can say like co-protocols. There are so many protocols will be used with VoIP. Some protocols from layer 4, some protocols in layer 5, okay, some protocols in layer 2. So there are plenty of protocols will work with VoIP. Okay, it is going to work with VoIP. So what are the such protocols means? In layer 2, point to point protocol, okay, or the link layer protocol such as PPP. So point to point protocol, frame relay protocol, ATM protocol. So all these protocols are going to work with the VoIP. Okay, then there are so many other protocols you can see in this diagram. I inserted this diagram. So here you can see what are all the different protocols which are running in the different layers means. So if you go for layer 2, point to point protocol, frame relay protocol, ATM protocol. These are the three things which are running in the layer 2. Then if you are seeing the layer 3, in layer 3, as usual we know, it is going to be IP and IPsec. Okay, so IPsec, it is basically for security, and IP protocol, okay, it is available in the layer 3. So in layer 4, we are having the TCP protocol and UDP protocol. So this is the communication, the basic communication protocols. Then the other protocols, if you see, okay, in different layers, okay, you can take it from, this is the application layer. you can take this two as presentation and session. So there are different protocols available here. So one is the TLS or SSL protocol. So this is for the security, transport layer security and SSL, secured socket layer protocol. Then RTP, so real-time transport protocol. Real-time transport protocol or secure real-time transport protocol. Then we have SIP. SIP means session initiation protocol. Okay, session initiation protocol. And we have two more protocols here, H323, H235. So these are all the different protocols which are running with the VoIP in different layers. Okay, in different layers. So this is about the overall thing. You can just go through the slides, you can understand here. Okay, so these are all the different protocols running in different layers. Then there is one more thing here that is a very important, we can say as a device or a software, or we can use a segment. We can use the word segment or component. So there is something called DSP, a digital signal processor. So the digital signal processor is a very important component of VoIP. It could be a hardware or it could be a software also. Okay, both. So you can have it in the software form or you can have it in a hardware form. And what is the main function, okay, of this mains? So this is going to segment, okay, it is going to divide or it is going to segment the voice signals into frames. So converting the voice signal into frames and then store them in the VoIP packets. Okay, so it is going to store in the VoIP packet. So DSP is a very important component as far as DSP is a very important component as far as VoIP is concerned. Okay, so these are all the different protocols which are running in the different layers of VoIP. Now I'm moving on to the next slide, VoIP benefits. So VoIP benefits, here technically it is given, but if you see non-technical things, there are a lot of advantages available. So the first thing is, okay, it will reduce the cost of the call. Okay, it is reducing the cost of the call, VoIP. That is a basic idea of VoIP. The second one, it can reduce the cost of devices. So you no need to buy many devices. You can reduce the devices. Then, okay, you will have your freedom. You no need to have to be in a fixed place. Okay, if you're going for the PSTN, public switch telephone network, so your device is fixed. You cannot take the device, okay, wherever you go. But whereas in VoIP, it is not like that. You can move. Okay, you can move from one place to another. That is, the mobility is there. So there are a lot of non-technical advantages. There are plenty of things available. So, but here they have given the technical. Okay, what are the technical advantages they are giving here? So, but you can see the first point. When you have the telephone, wherever you have an internet connection, so wherever the internet connection is available, you can start using the VoIP. That means you no need to have a fixed connection here. Okay, that is positive, the point one. The second one, you can bypass the PSTN, so no need to depend on your the traditional PSTN networks. Okay, public switch telephone networks, we no need to depend on that. You can, and also the charges. Okay, this is already I explained to you. So the charges of the call, okay, it's heavily reduced. Okay, comparing with PSTN, VoIP charges, that means are very, very economic, very less. Okay, then PSTN voice traffic and fax traffic offload. So offload means it is completely removed. Okay, that is called the offload concept. Universally accessible voice, mail and fax mail services. So anywhere to anywhere you can call. So there is no restriction here. So you can call from anywhere, universally accessible. Then a unified voice and data trunking, that means both your voice traffic and data traffic. So voice packets and data packets will be unified. So it will be sent in a single link itself. Okay, in the single link itself. So there is no differentiation here. Then, so plain old telephone services, internet telephone gateways. So what is it means? So we can use the ports as a gateway here. Okay, as a gateway, how we are going to see in the coming slides. Okay, there are two different approaches we are going to discuss. So we can see there. Then there are a lot of applications, plenty of different VoIP applications available. Okay, so we no need to depend only on the telephone. If you are going for the PSTN, if I want to talk, I have to go for the fixed telephone. Okay, I have to take it and I have to dial it. But here it is not like that. There are so many different applications available, plenty of different applications, including NetMeeting, okay, NetMeeting, Zoom, okay, WebEx. There are so many VoIP applications available nowadays. So you no need to depend on a particular application. So this is the benefits, the benefits of VoIP. Then moving on to the next one, layers. Relationship of OSI reference model to VoIP protocols and functions. So we are going to discuss what are all the protocols. This we already discussed in the previous slide, but anyway, it is arranged okay in a proper way. So you can see the OSI model. There are 7 layers available. Okay, so application, presentation, session, transport, network, and data link. So these are the 7 different layers. Sorry, a physical layer is missing. So that is going to be the cable. So the other 6 layers are given here. Then in each layer, what are all the VoIP protocols and functions? So majorly the protocols are given here. So application layer, you can have all the VoIP applications. There are plenty of VoIP applications available. Then in the presentation layer, we have code CS, or we can say this is coding decoding. Okay, coding decoding. So coding decoding is a protocol which is going to do encoding and decoding. Okay, converting from one form to another form. So this is codex, we can say codex. Okay, you can pronounce as you like. Okay, I don't have any restriction here. Then H.323 protocol, MGCP protocol, that is media gateway control protocol, SIP protocol, that means session initiation protocol. So these are all the session protocols which are used for the VoIP. Then in the transport layer, as usual, we know it is going to be the TCP, okay, transmission control protocol, UDP, user datagram protocol, RTP, real-time transport protocol. So RTP, yes, RTP is also available, secure real-time transport protocol. So these are all the different protocols available in the transport layer. So if you are going for the network layer, that means the layer 3, so IP protocol. So IP is a major protocol. Then in the data link layer, so these are all the different protocols we can have in the layer 2, okay. So frame relay, ATM, Ethernet, PPP, MLP, okay, and more. There are so many several other protocols. So in this slide, what we cover means, what are all the different protocols, okay, VoIP protocol, that means the protocols which are supporting VoIP, okay, across the layers, across different layers, okay, we discussed. Then the next slide, in this slide we are going to discuss about two primary applications for VoIP. So the first one, VoIP provides a central site telephony termination facility, okay, for voice traffics coming from multiple voice equipped remote office facilities. So what is this means? You can see we have two networks here. So this is a network. So the first one, this is a network, and this is the other network, the next network, two networks. So connected using, okay, the internet, that means wide area network. So completely it is IP based networks. Now in the first network, we have three devices, VoIP phones. So this is VoIP device, VoIP phone, or VoIP device, you can say anything. So these are the three devices available in this network and connected to a device. Okay, so this device, I'm going to say a central site telephony termination facility. That means this device is doing, or it is providing, okay, a service as, okay, telephony termination facilities for voice traffics which are coming from different places. Okay, which are coming from the different places. The same thing here, we are having a central device. So all the VoIP phones are connected to the central device. Then they are connected, okay, through a MGW, that means media gateway. Now you can see in both the networks we are having the media gateway. So media gateway is available here and media gateway is available here. Okay, now I want to make a call. Okay, for example, I'm in this mobile phone, I'm in this VoIP phone. This is my VoIP phone. It is available in my office. Okay, connected in the internet. That means connected in the network, local area network. Now I'm going to call. Okay, I'm going to call from this number. I want to call, okay, somebody who is available in the remote network. Okay, I want to call this particular person. So now I'm just calling and I'm going to talk to him. Okay, so my voice, whatever I'm talking, it will be converted into IP packets. Okay, it will be converted into the IP packets and all the voice, that means whatever I'm talking, so it will be converted and segmented into the IP packets, and the packets will be moving in the IP network. So now, so the packets is going to come from this device to the central device, okay, to the central device. Then the central device is going to forward it to the MGW. So this is the media gateway. So sometimes we can say media gateway, or we can say as a gatekeeper, okay, gatekeeper in a voice over IP network, in a VoIP network, we can call it as a gatekeeper also. So what is the functionality of this means? So it is traditionally used for call admission, call, that means allowing the call, then it is going to control the call, and also it is going to do the bandwidth management, okay. So there are a lot of things it is doing, but in the recently, that means in the latest technology, if you see, you no need to use a separate MGW, media gateway, we no need to use. We can use our ordinary gateway, that means we can use our ordinary router, we can enable the MGW functionality there. Media gateway functionality can be enabled in the ordinary gateway itself. Okay, the same thing. So my packet is reaching, that means VoIP packet is reaching the MGW, that means the media gateway, and it is going to forward it, okay, in the IP network, in the wide area network, it is reaching the next gateway. Then from the next gateway, so that packets, VoIP packets are going to be forwarded to the central device. So the central device is going to deliver the packet to the corresponding, okay, receiver. So this is the first functionality. So providing a central site telephony termination facilities for voice traffics coming from multiple voice equipped remote office facilities or remote offices. So this is the first function of VoIP. Then moving on to the second one. So in the second one, the second primary applications for VoIP is, it is going to provide a PSTN gateway functionality. So this is the important one. So our VoIP is going to provide, okay, a PSTN gateway functionality for the internet telephone traffic. So what is this? We can see here, see the topology diagram, you can understand very clearly. So these are all the VoIP phones, but I'm going to connect it by using the PSTN networks. So somebody is calling now, somebody is calling from the first number, for example, you take here. So they're calling from here means, so the call is will be forwarded through the PSTN, the traditional PSTN network, and it is coming to the central office. Then it will be received in a device. Okay, the name of the, okay, the device is Cisco AS5300, okay, device. So the same thing, so calls from different callers, the call is going through the PSTN network, okay, through the PSTN network. So it will be collected by a device. So the device is Cisco AS5300 device. So what is this device? What is the name of this device means? This is called Universal Gateway. Okay, it is a Universal Gateway. And what is the functionality of this device means? This is going to act as a PSTN gateway. Yes, you can see this is a PSTN network. This is not the IP network. In the previous topology diagram, we discussed, okay, IP network. There was an IP network and there was a device. Okay, a central device was there. You can see this is the IP network. A central device was here. So the central device was collecting all the calls. Then it is forwarded to the media gateway. But here what is happening means the calls are placed through the PSTN networks. Okay, the calls are coming through the PSTN networks. So it is collecting through the PSTN. Okay, then the AS5300, it is going to do some process. So we are now talking about this. So AS5300. Now I want to see this device, how this device will be teacher. Now you can see this is the device. So AS5300 device, okay, this is the device what you are seeing now. So this device is going to act as a PSTN gateway. Now, so what is the basic functionality of this device means? So to use VoIP, you must install the appropriate hardware, okay, the appropriate hardware is needed. So which is the appropriate hardware means? This is going to be the hardware, that means AS5300 is the hardware. So it is the universal gateway. So now, it is going to forward your calls, it is going to forward all your packets through the IP network, and it is going to reach the next network. In the next network, you can see we are having the gateway. So in the previous slide, we discussed about the media gateway, but now what the point I already, okay, registered means, we no need to have a media gateway. So instead of having media gateway, you can have an ordinary gateway in which you can enable the media gateway facilities. So here we are having a Cisco router, okay, an ordinary gateway. Then we have the central device. So this is the central device, okay, which is going to collect the calls and it is going to distribute the calls based on the receiver. So it will be received to a particular person who is going to receive the call. So these are the two major functions, okay, the two major applications of VoIP. Now I'm moving on to the next slide. The next one is PSTN call routing using the internet. So this is one of the important topic, okay, a technical topic we are going to discuss now. So PSTN call routing using the internet. So in the internet, using the internet, so how the PSTN call will be routed, that is going to be the major concept. So before that, some different cases we are going to see, okay. So what does that means? Usually from the residential telephone, so that means from our landline phone, okay, I'm taking my landline phone, uses residential telephone, okay, I'm going to make a call, okay, I'm going to make a call to someone. So the call should go through the internet, okay, that is a concept. So I'm going to call from a traditional telephone, from a PSTN phone, from a landline, a fixed line, you can say anything. I'm going to call someone in the other end, but my call should forward it through the internet. So how, what is happening in the background, okay, we are going to discuss here. So segment from the user residential telephone to the central office switch is assumed to be the analog and directly connected to the copper wire technology. So everything is going to be fixed. If you are going for the PSTN call, things will be fixed, okay, there will be already a fixed cable will be available, that is a copper wire. So there will be a central device, okay, we can say as an exchange. So there also they are going to do, okay, a direct connections, they are going to connect it, okay, all the data will be sent in the form of analog in a ordinary PSTN telephone. Then so this segment is often referred as a user to network interface, so we are going to say it as UNI. So UNI stands for user to network interface. Now I'm going for the first model, okay, the first case is traditional model. So what is a traditional model means? How a traditional PSTN network is going to work. So that is going to be the first part we are going to discuss. Then slowly we are going to go for the different cases. Okay, in the introduction slide I gave 5 different cases, okay, 5 different cases. We are now in the first case, okay, landline to landline, a fixed telephone to fixed telephone we are discussing here. Now you can see this is a phone, okay, a fixed telephone, okay, for example you take it, it is available in my residence, in my house. So I'm going to call somebody, okay, my friend who is in a different place. I'm going to call a number 2444 something, it starts with 2. So I'm going to call, automatically the call will be forwarded through a PSTN network, then he is going to receive the call. And also the same thing, okay, if he is calling, and automatically the call will be forwarded by using the PSTN network. So this is a traditional model of network, a traditional model of network. Now we are going to see what are the steps available. So what are the steps available means, now the phone is available like this, okay, so this is called on hook, ON, on hook, HOOK. So on hook means, that means the receiver, okay, the receiver is, okay, it's kept properly, so it is on hook. Now what is the first step means? The first step is you have to off hook, okay, you can see the word, please off hook the receiver, that means take the receiver. So the user picks up the receiver at the resident's phone, the central office recognize, okay, the central office is going to recognize, that means your exchange, okay, Omantel exchange or whatever the provider, so they are going to recognize, that means the receiver is in the off hook mode. So that means the receiver has taken, okay, this is off hook and this is on hook, okay, I just differentiate. So the first one is going to be on hook and the second one is off hook. So whenever you off hook your phone, automatically your provider will know that, so somebody is going to call. Then so immediately you are going to hear a sound. What is that means? That is called the dial tone. So a dial tone sound you are going to hear. Then on hearing the dial tone, so once if you hear the dial tone, the user is going to dial a sequence of numbers to reach the desired party. So you can call somebody 2456 somebody, you are going to dial the numbers, okay, in your that keypad, and you are going to dial it. Then in the central office he is successful in setting up the call. So the central office is going to set up a call for you, they are going to connect. Then once the successfully connected means the other end, that means the receiver is going to hear the ring. Okay, he is going to hear the sound. So the telephone starts ringing there. Then the receiver is going to pick up the phone. So conversation takes place. If the other party, that means the receiver, picks up the receiver. So the receiver is going to pick up the phone. So automatically you are going to talk. So the voice analog signal is carried by the UNI to the central office. So from your mobile phone to the central office, from the central office to the receiver. Now this is converted to a 64 kilobytes for carrying it, and for example through the PSTN using the TDM switching. So ordinary TDM switching they are using, time division multiplexing concept, and your call will be connected automatically. Your data, whatever the voice you are talking, it will be converted in the electrical signals. That means it will be converted as the analog signals, and it will reach the final party. Now so whenever you want to close the conversation, so if you want to close the conversation, either sender, that means the caller or the receiver, so they are going to unhook the phone. So once if you unhook the phone, automatically the call will be closed. So this is how normally a PSTN telephone is working. Okay, you can see the topology diagram given here. So this is a fixed line, fixed telephone, and this is a fixed telephone, so connected through a PSTN network, a traditional model. Okay, so this is what we discuss in this slide. Now I'm moving to the next slide, incorporation of an IP network. So now I'm going to bring an IP network into the picture. So I'm not going to use only the PSTN. So because I know only PSTN is going to be expensive, then there are a lot of other constraints. Okay, plenty of constraints available only using the PSTN. So what I'm going to do means I'm going to merge. Okay, I'm going to use both the internet and also the PSTN concept in this particular scenario. So this is the second one, incorporation of IP network. So you can see this is my phone, okay, my VoIP phone. So this VoIP phone, I'm going to connect it by using a voice adapter, a device. So it is now connected in a IP network. So through the IP network, so it is now again connected to the PSTN network, and through the PSTN network, okay, my device, that means my voice is delivered to the receiver. So here what we understand means, so only instead of having the PSTN network, we are now going to merge, okay, the PSTN with the IP network. Okay, that means the internet. So IP network and also the PSTN is merged together in this particular concept. It is not pure VoIP. I cannot say it is 100% VoIP, but it is working. It is working as a VoIP. But what is the main concept means, we have to remove completely the PSTN concept, should be removed. Okay, that is going to be the very important thing. Then the next one, incorporation of IP network. So if you are going to incorporate an IP network, there are two important aspects you have to consider. Okay, so what are they means? The first thing is replacing the direct line with a non-directed telephone connectivity mode. So there is a direct line will be available. If you are going for a pure PSTN based means, there will be a direct connection will be available. But if you are merging the IP network and PSTN, if you are merging means, so you need to replace these direct lines with a non-direct network connectivity mode. So the non-direct network connectivity mode, so what is that? Okay, it is coming. In the coming slides, we will discuss about it. Then changing the communication mode to a packet-based communication environment. So now your communication is completely going to be packet based. Okay, it is not going to be the analog one, electrical signals. Now the major changes, the two different changes we have to do. Okay, let me go to the previous slide. If you are going for the PSTN, you need a fixed line and you need, okay, like analog signals. Okay, the analog signals will be used for transferring your data. That means your data will be converted into analog signals and it will be transferred, okay, as an electrical pulse. But if you are incorporating the IP network, you need to do some changes. Okay, you need to do some changes. So what are the two major changes that we have to do means replacing the direct line with a non-direct network connectivity mode. So in the direct connectivity or the in the direct line, your packet, or you can say data, I'm using a generic word, data here, or voice, I use the word voice. So your voice will always go in a fixed line. The path will be very clear. Okay, the path will be very clear. But if you are going for a non-directed network connectivity means, the path okay, it is dynamic. The path will be dynamic. You cannot predict in which path, okay, your voice is going to move. So that is a non-directed network connectivity mode. Then, so you are going, your communication, your entire communication is going to be a packet based communication environment. Here, okay, you are not going to support, or you are not going to have a analog based communication. Okay, it is completely going to be a packet based communication environment. Then, to accommodate the PSTN network side, that means PSTN network side of UNI, for the above situation, the central office switch must have the adapter as well as, okay, there should be an adapter. We already discussed this in the previous slide. So this is going to be the voice adapter. A voice adapter should be available. So this is an additional equipment or a hardware device you need. Then the adapter is a media or a signal gateway. So this is going to be the gateway. We already discussed this in the previous slides, two different functions. Okay, it is going to act as a media gateway. So the it is going to be acting as a media gateway. Then this gateway function, then has the ability to communicate with the voice adapters for exchanging of call related messages. So it is going to control everything. Okay, I already explained in this particular slide for you. So what is the use of this MGW, media gateway? So this is going to like call admissions, call controlling, bandwidth management. So all these things it is going to do, the same points repeated here. So if you are having this gateway, so it is going to completely control, okay, connection related messages, okay, packetizations. So everything it is going to take care of. Then, so this gateway function can either be a physically integrated with the central office switch, or can separate server so that it can handle, okay, circuit mode functionality. So it can be a separate device, or you can just merge with, okay, you can merge with the switch, or even you can merge with the gateway, okay, your router. So there should be a media gateway. The media gateway is going to manage everything, controlling the call, okay, managing the bandwidth. So everything it is going to take care of that. Then in this slide we are going to see, okay, an example for PSTN call forwarding using the internet, that means using the IP network. Now you can see in this topology diagram there are two different types of networks or connector. So the first one is a IP network. So this is a IP network, and it is connected with a PSTN network, okay, public switch telephone network. Now, so there are some subscribers available. Okay, subscriber A, he wants to make a call, okay, a VoIP call. He wants to make a call to, okay, subscriber B. So what are the steps, or how the things are going to happen? Okay, we are going to see it as an example here. Now, in the previous slide we discussed about the formats, that means the addressing. So there are two different types of addressing are used. The first one is E164 or E.164. You can see this is E.164, okay, format. So it is something like our ordinary telephone number with country code, regional code, okay, etc. So here I am having a E.164 format, okay, a number is available, and this is the mobile number, sorry, the phone number, and this is the phone number. Okay, so you can identify which country it is by using the code. Then the next addressing is the IPv4 addressing. So you can see this is our IPv4 address. So we already know about it. So it is a 32-bit IP address with 4 octets. So these are the two different addresses that we are going to use it here. Then we already discussed about the device. Okay, so what is the device means? It is a VoIP adapter device. So this is a VoIP adapter device. So this device is going to have some session protocols, and it is going to do packetization. Okay, that means converting your voice data into packets. So all the other things, okay, session management, everything is going to take care of this device. Now we are going to see as an example. So here subscriber A, he wants to make a call to the subscriber B. Okay, so this is the scenario that we are going to take it here. Okay, now so this telephone, that means this is a fixed telephone, I'm going to use, okay, RJ11 connector. Okay, RJ11 connector I'm taking, and I'm going to connect this, okay, in the RJ11 jack. So this also we already discussed in the previous slide. Okay, there will be two different types of jacks, RJ11 jack and RJ45 jack. So here RJ11 we are connecting, because this is going to be a telephone line. Usually what type of cable will be used means here Cat1 cable. Okay, you might have studied about different types of cables. Okay, you might have studied about UTP cable. In UTP there are some categories available: Cat1, Cat2, Cat3 up to Cat7. So in Cat1, that means the Cat1 cables are used for connecting telephones. So here Cat1 cable will be used with RJ11 connectors. So it will be connected in the VoIP adapter. Then VoIP adapter is connected with the router here. So here what connector we are going to use means we are going to use RJ45 connector. Okay, RJ45 connector will be used here, and also here the RJ45 connector will be used. So now subscriber A, so he is connecting himself with the adapter. Then the next one, he wants to establish a call. He want to make a call to the subscriber B. Okay, so what are the steps means? The first step is subscriber A connects to the ports, that means plain old telephone service phone, to the VoIP adapter. So he will be connected with the VoIP adapter. That is step number one. Step number two is subscriber A connects the VoIP adapter to the internet. Now this will be connected with the internet by using RJ45 connector. So this is the second step. Then the third step is VoIP adapter requires an IP address. So we need an IP address. Okay, you can say 42.42.34.12. So there is an IP address. So this device needs an IP address. So the IP address will be given by this. Suppose, okay, DHCP will be running here, or anywhere DHCP will be available in this network. So automatically this device is requesting for an IP address. Okay, and this device will be offered with an IP address. So this is going to be the third step. Okay, very simple. First step is connecting this by using RJ11. Second step, connecting the adapter with the router using RJ45. The third step is, okay, assigning an IP address, an IPv4 address for the VoIP adapter. Okay, this is the third step. Then the VoIP adapter with IP address 42.42.34.12, it is going to start the initial configuration, that means the session, with the gateway. Okay, that means the gateway here, it is going to be the 2.98.179.1. So with this it is going to establish a connection. So I'll use a different color. So this device is going to establish a connection with this particular IP address. So this is going to be the fourth step. So here only we are using different protocols, session protocols we are going to use it. So the session protocols like SIP, session initiation protocol, okay, and RTP protocols. So these protocols, they are going to have a session, then it is going to do lot of functions, starting from packetization, okay, connection management, connection termination. So everything it is going to take care. Then the VoIP adapter, it is establishing the connection here, then automatically the session starts. Then since both these devices have internet address, okay, that means this device is having an internet address, IPv4 address, and this device, okay, it is having the IP address, IPv4 address. Okay, so whatever the packet generated here, whatever the packet it is creating, so that means after packetization, whatever the packet it is generating, simply it will be forwarded. It will be forwarded up to this. So there is no issues in that. Okay, so because this is also IP based, this is also IP based, IPv4 based. So whatever the packets forwarded by the adapter, so it will be simply, okay, reaching the, okay, reaching 2.98.179.1. Okay, so this particular place, that means this is a gateway. Okay, this is a gateway. So up to the gateway it is going to reach smoothly. Then the next part, it is going to be the PSTN. Okay, the next part is going to be the PSTN part. So in the PSTN part, here we are going to use a different routing method. So here ordinary IP routing method, so ordinary IP routing method will be followed in this, because it is an IP network. But here what is going to happen means, in the public switch telephone network, we are going for the switching method. That means it is going to be a TDM, time division multiplexing, or it is going to be a ordinary circuit. Okay, a circuit technique will be used, that is already whatever followed in the traditional telephone system. Okay, it is not routing, it is switching. So a switching technique mechanism will be followed here, then the packet will be delivered to this particular machine. So this is how the things will be working. So if you are going for if you are combining the IP network with the PSTN network. Now So this is explained in the next slide. You can see all the steps. So whatever the steps I have given to you, so all these things it is given here. So step number 1, step number 2, then what are the things happening, okay, it is explained here. So kindly go through the slides so you can understand better. Now the next one is service observation and challenges. So what are the various challenges available? So if you are going for PSTN call routing using the internet, using IP network, okay, so if you are going for that, what are the different challenges and what are the things you have to observe, okay, in this particular scenario? So that we are going to discuss in this particular slide. So if you see the challenges, VoIP adapter, okay, the VoIP adapter, it should be run continuously, so it needs additional electricity, so power it needs, okay, so it will be keep on running, you cannot switch it off and switch it on again and again. So the VoIP adapter, it is going to consume the electricity, so this is one of the challenge you can see here. So if there is a loss of electricity, suppose if the electricity is okay cut or power off, means automatically your VoIP adapter is not going to work and you cannot have a VoIP service. But it is not in the case of PSTN. If you are having a PSTN network, even if there is a power failure, no issues, you can use the PSTN networks, okay, ordinary networks, ordinary telephone, you can use it, landline telephone, even if there is no power. But if you are going for VoIP based, okay, that means PSTN call routing using, okay, IP, if you are going, so in that case, okay, if there is any power problem, suppose if the adapter, VoIP adapter is not working, then it's an issue, okay. So VoIP adapter is located, then the subscriber cannot avail itself for the phone service. So this is not to be confused with the purposely turning off the VoIP power, much like turning off the mobile phones, okay. So that means if you switch on, if you switch it off, it's a different issue. Suppose if the electricity is not available, power cut problem means, so it is going to affect the VoIP service, okay. So this is the first issue here. Then the second one, every time it is not, that means your VoIP adapter is not going to have a static IP address, it's not a fixed IP address, okay, it is not tied, it is not tied, VoIP adapter is not tied to any fixed IP address. So it is going to, every time it will take a dynamic, okay, because by using the DHCP, every time your VoIP adapter is going to acquire, or it is going to get a different IP address, a dynamic IP address is going to be used. So this is the second, I cannot say it is a challenge, we can observe this, these are all the issues, the places where you will get the issues. Then the next one is a very important one, it is called the location probability. So what is location probability means, you can see the ability to take the VoIP adapter and connect to the internet from anywhere, okay, that means I have an VoIP adapter in my home, so I want to take this VoIP adapter and I want to use it anywhere, okay, so anywhere is great interest of the subscriber, so subscribers, they need mobility, they need, so this is this way, any local call to which this telephone number was assigned is still a local call. In essence, this function provides a location probability, so that means you can take this VoIP adapter, you can use it in some other place where you are having internet and it will be considered as, okay, a local call only, okay, a telephone only. So this is called the location probability. You can change the location, okay, that is what exactly we are trying to say here. So location probability is there, but however, what is the problem in the location probability means, see, the location probability however creates some problems in certain situation. What is that? So for example, subscriber A, who has the number, so this is the number, okay, takes the VoIP adapter anywhere and connects to the internet, then dials 911, okay, for example, if you take Oman, 9999 is the emergency number, so this service will work only inside Oman. But I'm taking the VoIP adapter, I'm moving it to some other country and trying, means it is not going to work, okay, it is not going to work. So this is some slight drawbacks also available, okay, we cannot say drawback, these are all different situations, okay, different cases, okay, it may arise. So location probability, you can change your location, but once if you change the location of your VoIP adapters, automatically you will lose some services, you cannot get, some services you can get it, okay. So this is the concept of service observations, okay, this is what are all the overall things what we are observing. as far as VoIP adapter is concerned. Okay, that is the only importance. Okay, only the device we are taking and we are talking about it. As far as VoIP adapter is concerned, these are all the different challenges available. Now, we are moving to the next topic, the last topic in this lecture, managed IP approach. Managed IP approach. So here, what we are going to do means, in the previous example, that means we discussed about the PSTN call routing using the internet, that means using the IP network. There we used a device called VoIP adapter device. This VoIP adapter device, it is going to take the IP address dynamically from the router. Okay, that is what we discussed. So it is not going to have a static IP address. So here, what is the concept means? We are going to have a managed IP approach. That means we are not going to, the device is not going to acquire any IP address dynamically. Plus, we are not at all using the VoIP adapter. Okay, I'm going to remove the VoIP adapter, and instead of that, I'm going to have a new device. It is not device. We are going to have a new adapter which is called embedded multimedia terminal adapters. So we are going to, instead of VoIP adapters, we are going to use embedded multimedia terminal adapters, EMTA. The same concept here also, it is going to have the RJ11 jacks, and also it is going to have RJ45 jack. So RJ11 jack is used for connecting the telephones, your landline telephone, and then RJ45 is used for connecting with the routers or with the IP network. Now, so this EMTA, that means embedded multimedia terminal adapters, it is not only going to handle the voice packets, with the voice, the other multimedia things also it is going to be included. Okay, you can see here, addition to the voice, such terminals are intended for multimedia services. So different services it is going to provide, including voice. So the previous one we are going to talk about only about the voice services, but here the other different services also it is going to provide. Now, so the conceptual architecture for cable IP networking for telephony is shown in the figure below. That means in the next slide we are having the architecture for cable IP networking for telephony services. So in this topology diagram, so what we understand means the same concept, but in a elaborated way we added some more things. You can see this. So this is going to be our PSTN port, and this is going to be your IP port, so this is our IP network. So what is the concept here? So PSTN calling, using the, that means PSTN call routing using the internet, using the IP network. So that means my call should go through a IP network, then it is going to a PSTN network, then it will reach the final destination. So this is the concept. In the previous case, we used VoIP adapters, but here we are going to use, the new things. So that is going to be the EMTA, that means embedded multimedia terminal adapters we are going to use. Now, so in this topology diagram, you can see the telephone, this is going to be our telephone. It is now connected with a device called MTA, MTA, or we can say as a CM. So CM means it is a cable modem, or MTA. So MTA is multimedia terminal adapter. Now this adapter, that means this end, it is provided by the ISP, the internet service provider. They are going to provide this to you. This is called the cable modem service. Now you are going to connect, by using the RJ connector, RJ11, you are going to connect your phone. That's it. So up to this, it will be provided by the by your provider, telecommunication provider. In the previous one, adapter you have to buy. You are going to buy and you are going to use as an external device. But here the MTA CM, multimedia terminal adapter, in this, up to this, that means your ISP is going to take care. So what does it mean? IP address, you are not going to worry about the IP address. So this is going to be the managed IP address. So the IP address will be managed by the ISP only. So the locally you are not going to manage any IP address. So IP networking available at the customer's home, that means this will be available in the customer's home. home utilizes the cable facilities that is already belong to the provider. Okay, it is already belongs to the provider through the cable modem service. Then, so the customers, what they will do means they are going to connect it and they are going to have the EMTA services. Okay, all the services they can have. Then the cable modem is visible to the cable modem termination system. So the CMTS is called cable modem termination system, and there will be some protocol. They are using the protocol called DOCSIS protocol. So that means data over cable service, okay, interface specification protocol. Okay, I repeat, data over cable service interface specification protocol. So there are different versions available, DOCSIS, there are different versions available. Okay, 1.1, okay, 1.1 is a very common version, and this will provide the quality of service. Then it should be noted that the CMTS is primarily a layer device, that is, it is going to be a layer 3 device. Okay, and this is integrated with the layer 3 of the router for IP communication. So this device, it is a layer 3 device, CMTS device, and also router, we already know it is going to be a layer 3 device. So both the device, they are going to communicate only using the IP address. In the layer 3, they are going to communicate. Then from the EMTA, that means from this device at home to the call manager server, this entire call manager server means, okay, it is going to be up to this. This is the call manager server or service. So here we are having different services. So providing the call agent, media gateway controlling. Okay, we already discussed about the media gateway, mobile gateway, signaling gateway. So up to this, the entire thing, all the communication, it is going to take care only using packets. That means layer 3 communication. Okay, layer 3 communications only. So then, okay, that means it is going to have a effective routing. So what is the difference between the previous approach and here means only this part. Okay, only this part. So there we use the VoIP adapter, but here, okay, we remove the VoIP adapter. Instead of that, we use MTA and CMTS. Okay, so these are the different things. So once the packet reaches the PSTN network, already switching concept. Okay, the old method, the traditional method of switching will be going on in this particular environment. So this is how we can have a different connections by using the MTA concept. Okay, so you can go through the next two slides. So they are explaining the steps. Okay, step by step, step number one, step number two, okay, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 different steps they are giving here. So and how the EMTA, okay, and other things are working, it is explained in this particular slides. Okay, thank you very much. Keep watching.